the team news, Kulusevski, Richarlison, Benton Club, any other news?
The news, for sure the situation is going to improve, and especially for Deki, for Kulusevski, and he had the training session the last few days with us, and I think he's going to be ready to play. About Richie and Rodrigo, also both situations are improving. I think in this moment Deki is much more ready to play, especially don't take risk. Because for us it will be very, very important to have patience. Especially because we lost these important players for a long period, and then now to accelerate the process to recover and to risk to lose them for a long period again, I think that is not good, is not positive. For this reason, we'll see. We have another training session tomorrow to monitor it well. The situation about Rodrigo and Richie.
So mid-January now coming up too. Fabio Paratici never off his phone. is there any progress with any transfers in Pedro Porro, Leandro Trossard? Any other news? Many big games coming up.
But about the transfer market, you know very well that I don't like to speak a lot. I think that in this moment my focus is totally for the team, because we had to face important games and against Arsenal, then against City, Fulham, against City again, FA Cup. This moment I'm really focused on the pitch. Then about the transfer market, I'm sure the club is trying to monitor it, the situation.
Tottenham Arsenal, big local rivalry. Mikel Arteta once said, trust the process, and they had some very poor finishes, but now they are top of the league. He's made some good recruitment, many players he didn't want out, many in. Is that how you see your challenge here at Tottenham? You once said to me this squad needs a lot of work. How do you see it over this window in the next few years?
Yeah, but usually I don't like to see other teams, other situations, because I think for every club there is a different situation, and for sure they are doing a really good job, but don't forget that this job has started 3 years ago, maybe not 3 years and a half ago. And for this reason, as you said, many players went out, many players came in, and this is normal. This is normal. Now I think that they are showing that they are in the right direction. They are first in the Premier League. They are at top of the table, and but especially they are deserving to stay in this position. It's not for lucky, but because in every game they showed to be a really good team, a really strong team, a team that showed to be solid, no? Solid. And but at the same time, I think that I have to look to ourselves, and for sure I continue to repeat the same situation. And I think that we are working very hard. We are working very hard in these 14 months. We work strong, work hard. The whole compartment in Tottenham. To try to build something important, to be more solid, and I think that we are working in the right direction, and we have to continue in this way, and to try to, at the same time, to find a good result, because you know very well, good results are really important for every process.
Thanks, Michael. Niv?
Hi, John.
Good afternoon.
How would you describe the confidence level and the momentum of your team going into this game against Arsenal this weekend?
The confidence, and we lost a game against Aston Villa at home, and then we won away against Crystal Palace, a good game for Neil, and then in FA Cup we are in the next round. I think the moment is a good moment. It's a good moment because the players wants to work very hard, and they understood the importance after the World Cup to go quickly into the football in Premier League, into the competition FA Cup, and for this reason I'm seeing them really focused. They know much more than me the importance of this type of game. Then when you play against important team, you know, like Arsenal, Manchester City, and you know the tension is very high. And for me, it's not so difficult to keep the focus, to keep the tension for the players. Now, I repeat, for us, we will be very, very important, and I think we are really close to recover all the players in our squad, and then to be ready to face this long run until the end of the season.
You speak very often about the connection with the fans. This Sunday at home, what do you expect?
My expectation is always the same, and our fans, they never disappointed us, because in every moment of the season, they show it to be back to stay with us and in a positive and negative situation. For sure, we know very well the importance of this game for the fans, for the rivalry there is between Tottenham and Arsenal. Last season, I remember a fantastic atmosphere, an amazing atmosphere. I'm sure also in this game we'll find the same atmosphere.
Ian?
Hi, Antonio.
Hi.
We stand on the precipice of the history of this club. For the first time in more than 50 years, Harry Kane could break the goal-scoring record of Jimmy Greaves, could do it this weekend. Can you explain to us, in your opinion, how important he's been? Because he's been very loyal to this club. Obviously, you're hoping he'll sign another contract at the club. And his goal-scoring record matches anybody in world football over the last decade.
But you know very well, much better than me, the importance of Harry for us, for Tottenham, but also for the national team, because with the club, with the national team, he has great numbers, and we are talking about a world class striker, and. For sure, he's going to beat every record. I think he deserves this. But I want always to underline also the other aspect, the human aspect about Harry, because it's not we are talking not only about a world class striker, but also a really good man, a really good person, and. For us, is an important point of reference, and I'm sure that he's going to beat this record, and he's doing something of incredible. And at the same time, we try to help him, and if he scores, he helps he helps us. Yeah, this is important. Yeah, to have this this exchange of favor. Yeah.
And Sunday is not going to be quiet on the touchline. We've seen in recent weeks that Mikel Arteta is very passionate on the touchline. Spurs even have a camera and a YouTube. They've got a YouTube Conte cam for you running up and down the touchline, getting all excited when your team scores and encouraging them on. That passion on the touchline, how important is that for your team to see, and how important is that for your fans to see?
But, you know, I think that everyone try to leave the situation in the way that likes to live, you understand? And for sure, also Arteta is another coach that show his passion and transfer this into the pitch to his players. Yeah, and but honestly, I'm seeing a lot of coaches that they are totally involved during the game, because now our job became really difficult, and to see coach to stay sit, no, and the bench is very, very difficult, and for sure, and Arteta is a coach like me. We show our passion, and what happened during the pitch, and is the moment, is the motion, nothing of preparing your mind, and for this reason, sometimes you can celebrate in a strange way, no? But this passion is a pure passion. And Arteta, for sure, is another coach that likes to live the game, likes to stay into the pitch with his team.
Thanks, Ian. Ali? Hey.
One player you didn't mention in the injury news is Lucas Moura. Obviously, we know he's had his problems this season with his injury, and it's come out this week that the club aren't going to take the option to extend his contract. Can you just kind of put into words really what season it's been for him, and what a bit of a nightmare, I guess, season for him, and also, I guess, about his future?
But you know, and these are decisions of the club, and for sure this season is a difficult season for Lucas, but at the same time also for us, because honestly, in my mind, when we planned the season, Lucas was an important player for us. And if you see from the start of the season until now, Lucas played one game, and also with pain, and in Champions League against Marseille, and then also not all game, no, with us. And first of all, I think that the damage is for me, for the team. Because a player like Lucas is a good player, and also last season he helped us to reach the Champions League. In my mind, in my plan was into my squad, and don't have the possibility to use him, and for the injuries and. Was really difficult, especially because in this season it happened twice that Kulusevski and Richarlison was injured. And, yeah, and to face this situation wasn't easy. It's not easy. Then, if you ask me about the decision of the club, this I respect the decision of the club.
You're not entirely sure when you're going to have him back, and if he's able to play without pain at all, is that a position, because you like two players in every position, is that a position this month maybe you do need to bring someone in because of that problem?
But, you know, and when we started the season, And Lucas was one of the five strikers. We played with the three strikers. And then he was one of these five strikers instead. And for this injury, and I faced the season with only four strikers. And then also, you know, Gil, you are talking about a young player, a really, really good prospect, that last season he struggled about physical aspect. And now we are trying to develop, no, to accelerate his process to help us, because for me it's very important to have an alternative, an option in front up. For sure, I repeat. And Lucas, from the start of the season, I count about him, but for the injury, he was never present to help us.
Okay, final one for this section. James, please.
Hi. Ross has been charged by the FA for failing to control their players in their last two matches against Oxford and Newcastle for surrounding the referee, trying to intimidate the referee. Do you have any concerns that they may do that in the big game on Sunday?
No, no. I think that... I like and to, yeah, also in an important game like this, and the respect is always at the top. Okay, we have to show respect in every situation, and especially also with the referee, because I know very well the difficulty to be referee, to take a decision. I think to intimidate or to create a bad atmosphere is not fair. I don't like this, and I hate the people that try to do it. And don't forget that we are talking always about a game of football. Sometimes happen for the motion, no? For the motion that I remember very well. I guess Sporting Lisbon. We scored 95 minutes, and then we stayed 5 minutes to wait the VAR decision. And then I was really upset, but I never lacked the respect of the referee. Then he sent me away because I went into the pitch. Okay, but I think in every moment you have to show respect, and don't forget that this football. An incredible sport, and we have to respect each other.